Hi, my name is Sarah, and I'm from LA. Please like and subscribe because My Story Animated will give $1,000 to one lucky person who subscribes in the next 7 days. My parents were only 16 when they had me, but I never knew them. They passed away soon after I was born, and I grew up with my grandma, and she was crazy. Grandma had wild parties and concert-like shows in her house with all her girlfriends. And she even had a mini pool. Look at me, I'm a mermaid, I can fly! Well, she couldn't, but it was fun to watch her and laugh. Once when I was 3, my preschool teacher called my granny and told her that I might have some speech problems. Granny got mad and came running like a cheetah. She barged in and attacked my teacher. How can you say that my grandchild is dumb, you moron? She is perfect, just like me. All the kids were crying and screaming. I got scared and peed my pants. Some teachers came and pulled her away. Grandma then decided to enroll me in a different school. She was only 40, but she behaved like she was 20. When I was 4, my world turned upside down one day. Grandma was freaking pregnant. A few months passed and Grandma gave birth to a baby girl, Emma. But she was a devilish child. She would crawl around the house stealing my stuff and then throw it all into the toilet. Emma! Once when she was 4, I saw Emma trashing all my favorite clothes with scissors. Oh my God, Emma! What are you doing? That's my favorite dress. I know, it's the best one you have. Next time, I will cut it while you are wearing it. So maybe I can cut your arm too.
Oh, just look at her, Sarah. How could you get mad at her cuteness?
Cuteness? This was craziness, and it was killing me. Once when she was 5, she set the living room on fire and called the police herself. Luckily, I came on time and was able to put out the fire before any harm was done. When the police officer arrived, Emma started yelling,
"It's Sarah! She wanted to kill me!"
The cop looked at me and nodded.
"It's okay. We deal with kids like her. Don't worry, we're not arresting you."
As the cop was leaving without me, Emma ran to him and bit his leg really hard. And when we tried to stop her, she scratched us with her devilish nails. Emma! She was crazier than Grandma herself, and the only escape I had from her was school. But soon, that happiness was also ruined when she joined the same school as mine. On the very first day, she told everyone that she was my aunt and other stupid stories about me.
She pees in her sleep and eats her boogers.
Emma, stop it! How dare you?
Oh, someone, please save me! She's gonna kill me! She's really mean to me at home, too!
Oh my God, what a drama queen she was. Because of her fake acting and false rumors, everyone at school thought I was the bad guy. One time in the 7th grade, I was playing basketball on the court when she came and insisted she'd play too. "You're too young for this, Emma."
"You're too young for this, Emma."
Ugh, stop it.
Ugh, stop it.
Fine, but be careful. I let her play because I didn't want her to create another scene in front of everyone. But God, she was actually good at this. Within seconds, the other team was losing so badly. But suddenly, I saw Emma fall to the ground and she screamed in pain.
I can't move my legs.
I immediately called Grandma and we rushed her over to the doctor. He finally told us that Emma had some neurological issues and she would never walk properly again, let alone play. When Emma heard this terrible news, she burst into tears, and Granny looked so sad. It just broke my heart. We had to get her a wheelchair, and suddenly, everything changed. Grandma stopped her wild parties and stayed at home as much as possible. I started sleeping in Emma's room so that I could help her. One night, when I saw her struggling to go to the bathroom, I ran to pick her up, but she slapped me really hard.
"I can go to the bathroom myself. I don't need you."
Whoa, that was totally uncalled for. But I let her go on her own. And then a few moments later, I could hear her crying inside, and I felt awful. But the very next morning, when I took the first bite of my food, I immediately spat it out. It tasted like dirt. I looked at Emma, and she had this wicked smile on her face. "What's this? What did you put in this, Emma?"
She stuck her tongue out at me and then took the bowl of soup and poured it all over her head. Then she ran to Granny in her wheelchair.
Mom, look, Sarah did this to me and she says I'm a burden on this earth.
Sarah, I can't believe you're being this terrible to your own aunt. You should be ashamed of yourself.
But I didn't do anything.
So, you mean she poured soup over herself?
Yes, she did. That's what she always does. At school and here, she always fakes everything to put the blame on me.
That's enough, Sarah. I've had enough of your stories. Apologize to Emma right now.
And then Emma burst into crocodile tears and hugged Granny. This was so wrong. Just because she had this problem didn't mean she could make my life hell now. I was so angry that I just stormed out of the house and went to get some ice cream. Just then, I received a text from Grandma's phone. You're a Hiawan. Hiawan? What was that? But then, suddenly a girl who was standing next to me in line laughed. That person is a jerk. I looked up to see... Oh my God! What? Sniper Wolf? OMG, I love your videos. I've been following you for so long.
Why, thank you. But that person you're texting, is she an Arab?
No, that's just my little sister. Wait, you're from Iraq, aren't you? You don't look Arab, though.
Oh, let me go get some milk and my camel and invite you to my tent. Then you might believe me.
Oh, sorry, that's not what I meant. You're so funny, Leah, and such a queen.
Yes, yes. And let me tell you, that word, Hiawan, that's Arabic, and it means animal.
What? Grandma thought I was an animal? I felt so upset. But then Sniper Wolf saw right through me and hugged me. She asked me what happened, and I told her all about it. It's okay to be sad and feel this way, but I can tell that you're really strong. Just believe in yourself and be kind to others. That's all that matters.
Oh, she's the sweetest. I loved Sniper Wolf even more now. And I made sure to follow her advice.
A few days later, I walked into the school backyard, and to my shock, I saw a bunch of senior kids messing around with Emma. They were running around in circles with her lunch.
Catch me if you can. Catch me if you can.
Stop it. Give me back my lunch. My sister made it for me. OMG. These guys were so gonna get killed by me. I charged at them angrily. Give her the lunch back, you jerks.
Ho ho ho, we're so scared. Are you gonna kill us with your cuteness? We just wanted to ride her chair for a bit. What's wrong with sharing?
This was it. I kicked him hard in his leg and he fell to the ground. Now you can ride one for real. Leave before I kick all of your butts. As they ran off, I turned to Emma and she almost had tears in her eyes. She whispered a thank you to me and then I took her home. She didn't say a word the entire way, but I felt so terrible for not knowing earlier what she'd been going through. After that, I made sure to look after her all the time. I also started playing basketball again. Emma loved it so much, and I wanted to make her proud of me. At the final basketball match for the national selection, I invited both Emma and Granny to come watch me. While I was changing in the dressing room, someone locked me in there. I kept screaming and shouting, but no one opened the freaking door. Hours later, the door opened, and I was shocked to see Emma there. Oh my God, Emma, I didn't know who locked me in here. I missed everything, didn't I?
Yeah, you did. And I locked you in.
I stared at her in complete shock. You? But why? Are you crazy? Why would you do that?
Because I just hate you. You're a Hiawan.
Hiawan? OMG. It was you, wasn't it? You texted me that word from Granny's phone.
So what if I did? It fits you perfectly.
What did I ever do to you, Emma? Why are you doing this to me? You're like my sister.
No, I'm not. I'm just your child aunt that you're so ashamed of. You have this perfect life where you have everything. And me? I'm just a kid with no talent and no walking legs. I can't even play basketball that I love so much. So I won't let you play either.
I can't believe you do something so terrible to me. It was my dream. I thought you'd be proud to see me play. But now I see that you can't stand to see me happy.
I stormed out of there and didn't talk to her for weeks. I was so angry and heartbroken. But soon, Emma's science fair came around, and Granny came down with the flu. I really didn't want to go, but I didn't want Emma to be alone either. So reluctantly, I went. When I got there, I found Emma in tears. Her project was all broken, and all her team members were gone. Oh, God, Emma, what happened here?
I accidentally crashed into the project model, and it broke. All my team members left me saying it was my fault. And now I don't know what to do anymore. It's only 2 hours until the judges come in.
It's okay. Don't worry, Emma. I'm here for you. I'll help you fix it. I borrowed some tools from someone and helped Emma quickly build her project once again. When the judges arrived, they were amazed to see such an awesome working model that was built using all these random materials. I shrieked in delight when they announced the winner. It was Emma, and she rolled onto the stage to receive the award. She then went ahead to speak on the microphone, and I teared up when she called out my name.
I'm so grateful to Sarah, my sister, who helped me build this awesome project today. She's an amazing person who's always ready to catch me when I fall. But I've done some terrible, terrible things to her. The truth is, I wasn't even mad at her. I was just unhappy with myself. I really want to apologize to her and thank her for everything she's done for me. I'm differently abled and strong because of you, Sarah. Please, forgive me. Forgive your little sister.
As the crowd cheered and applauded, I rushed to the stage and hugged her.
I love you so much, Sarah. You're the best person in the whole world.
I love you too, Emma. After that, Emma and I grew quite close.
Like a cool drop of rain coming down from a clear sky. Oh, yeah. Like a honeybee taking off that really shouldn't fly. Oh, yeah.